Om Sri Sai Ram. Our loving pranams at the lotus feet of Bhagawan Sri Satya Sai Baba. Sai Ram uncles, aunties, brothers and sisters. On this auspicious day, we are proud to present you a drama entitled Mother is Precious. A brother and a sister were heading back home from tuition.
While they were on their way home, they had a conversation between them.
Hey sister, Mother's Day is coming soon. So, what is your plan?
No plans now. But lately did you realize Mom is behaving so different? I can't tolerate it.
True sister, I didn't realize that. She's so cruel to our grandma. Poor grandma.
When they reached home,
hey, you, come here, clean this for me. Look at what that idiot woman did to my clothes. Wait till your son comes home and I will tell him what mess you have done to me.
Mom, Mom, why are you so angry? What happened? Please, be calm.
My sister actually...
Hey, did they ask you anything? Go. Go and do your work. My dear, look at what your grandma did to my costly clothes. She purposely poured the coffee on him. What am I to wear now for the function? That was the best.
Mom, don't worry. You'll have better ones too. She's too old. I'm sure it was an accident. Please forgive her. Okay, well, go and change.
These two always support her. They don't understand my feelings.
Bimal calls the children and explains the true incident.
My dear, your mom was actually eating your grandma. She was too angry after work and started punishing her. To protect herself, she accidentally hit the table and the coffee poured. It's not your grandma's fault.
Yes, I know that. But why is mom behaving like this? Oh, Swami.
The next day, Mr. Arun was at home. While he was reading the newspaper, all of a sudden...
Ew! Sick!
What happened? Why are you screaming?
Look! Look what your mom did!
I actually slipped and fell in the toilet, my son. That's why.
Mom! Oh my God! Please be careful! There's no one even to help you to the toilet.
Don't worry about me, son. Swami will take care of me. I'm perfectly fine.
Anita! Anita! Please assist your grandma to her room.
Mr. Arun tells Anita to assist grandma to the room to give her some medications. Then Mrs. Priya calls her husband to complain.
You saw what happened right just now. How come you remain silent and not taking any action?
Just stop it, okay? She's my mom and that was an accident. Why are you being so aggressive? Stop complaining and go do your work. Go!
Father, I can't tolerate mom's behavior. Poor grandma. She's always finding fault on her.
You are right, AJ. I realize that her behavior is getting worse. She's always finding faults and creating problems with her.
While Mrs. Priya was walking in the garden, she purposely pushes grandma to the ground, who was plucking some flowers there. Mr. Arun saw what happened through the room window and rushes to the garden.
Hey, stop it! This is so cruel! I saw what you did to my mother. Please respect elders and remember, karma will hit you back when you get old.
No, no, don't scold her. Please forgive her.
Oh, Mother, I feel so sad for you. Oh, Swami, please be with her. Always.
Mm-hmm. in the living room. Grandma walks around to find her glasses. Then suddenly,
oh my God! I don't think I'll leave before my daughter-in-law comes.
Mrs. Priya vents her anger on Grandma by pushing her against the wall. At the same time, Mr. Arun, AJ and Anita return home for lunch.
Mara, what happened? Can someone please tell me what happened?
Actually, Grandma, she ran away.
Wait! Did he ask you anything? No, right? Go to the kitchen and bring 2 cups of tea.
No, dear. Your mom eventually fell while she was fighting for her spectacles. I'm just massaging her.
Vimana once again called the kids and told them the actual story. The children then explained this to their father. Mr. Arun told them to see what would happen next. Mrs. Priya went on complaining about Grandma to her husband, and the conversation turned into a fight. They fight, fight and fight.
Arun, you better take a decision right now. I cannot tolerate with your mother anymore. She's ruined my happiness. She's either breaking my precious gift or not ruining my costly clothes. I don't want her to stay in this house anymore. You better do something about it, Arun.
You have no rights to talk about your mother like this.
I have all rights. I'm your wife.
You better keep quiet. Don't make me slap you, okay?
You think you can slap me?
Yes, I do.
How dare you beat me?
Hello, I've been listening to your car. She has been using me to do all her duties and always blaming Grandma. You're always putting all the blame to Grandma and was treating me as a maid. She's not eligible either to be my sister. No, mother for children. I know what she did to Grandma. Poor Grandma. She does not make it a big issue. Oh God. You must take care of everything. He will surely punish her for all her deeds.
Hey, you better watch your words.
What may you? Will you stop me, huh? Now it's my turn to talk. You think it's your home so you can just rule me? What do you want from the old lady? You're not fit to be a woman but a limited human. Oh God, I'm sorry but I'm leaving this place.
Even he can voice her now. It is all because of your mom. She created all this. She has bad intention on me. She's not supposed to stay here
anymore. Just stop me, okay? Work tension, home tension, everywhere tension. I'm sick of this. Please change your attitude for God's sake. Oh, Swami, Swami.
As there is no one to support Mrs. Priya, she goes to seek help from her neighbor, Mrs. Shanti, who has the same evil attitude as her.
Shanti! Shanti! Where are you?
Yes, Priya. Why? Anything? You look very different.
Yes, Shanti. I'm having problems at home. My brother scolded me and he left my house.
Yes, sir. But why? I heard rumors around the neighborhood saying that you are ill-treating your mother-in-law and always punishing her. I was thinking of meeting you regarding this.
My brother said that he can't tolerate with me anymore and he left. Ill-treating her? It's all fake. That old lady is the main culprit for all this problem. I lost my happiness at home because of her. I called you to seek help to get rid of that old lady. Do you have any idea?
Don't worry, Priya. Let me think. Hey, I have an idea.
Yes, what is it?
I know a paranormal expert. I'm sure he can give you a solution for your problem.
What? You are trying to jump in me, is it?
No, no, listen. We go and seek advice from the expert. What do you say?
I guess it's a great idea. When? When shall we meet him?
Why not? I make an appointment for tonight.
Alright then. WhatsApp me once the appointment is done. Bye.
After making an appointment, Mrs. Priya and Mrs. Shanti go to seek help from the paranormal expert.
Om Sri Kali Suri Holi.
Holi? Isn't that a festival?
Om Bhaja 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 Jai Sarvabhar Ramesh.
Yes, how can I help you?
Yes, sir. I was the one who called you this afternoon for an appointment. She is my neighbor, Priya, and she needs help from you.
All right. Please explain what it is.
It's all about my mother-in-law. She's ruining my happiness. My husband and also my children are all on her side. I need to get rid of that old lady from my house. Please, I need an idea.
Oh, okay. You know why I became a homo? It's because of my mother-in-law. Wait, let me discuss with my seafood first.
Why is it taking so long for you to die?
Wait, la. The number must reach you, man.
Mangisa, pingisa, pingisa, payasa, payasa, kayasa. Kaya sama ya sama.
Ah, ayo malu malu. Ah, esok kita malu malu. Okay, my sifu told me a solution. To get rid of your mother-in-law is difficult. So I have to possess your husband, where he will be agreeing to your decisions. Then it will be easy to get rid of your mother-in-law and tie it on your husband's hand. After that, he will be your slave. Remember, this curse will not work if the string is removed.
No problem, sir. I understand. Thank you very much.
Hello, hello. Payment, payment.
Mrs. Priya went home that night and saw her husband fast asleep. She takes the opportunity to tie the string around his wrist.
Darling, good morning. I want to tell you something.
Yeah, baby. What is it?
Darling, I think of sending your mother to the old folks' home. What do you think? We need some space and happiness as well, right? It's been a long time we spent our life as a family.
Oh, why not? Once I reach the office, I'll book a place in the home. You have been packing her purse, okay?
Yes, the spell is working. I love you, darling. Yeah, sure, we'll do that immediately.
Angie and Anita overheard all the parents' conversation. They immediately rushed to their grandmother to inform her.
Grandma, Grandma, I heard from my parents that they are planning to send you to the old folks' home.
Yes, Grandma, please don't leave us. We love you.
You're in very great children. So be able to take care of me.
Thank you.
It's nice to see you, sir. How can I help you?
Actually, we are here to drop my mother. She needs extra care, and as we are too busy, we really can't take it to take care of her. So, hope you understand.
Okay, I understand, sir. Let's proceed with the arrangements.
They made all the necessary arrangements. Grandma was strong that Swami would take care of everything. After everything was settled, Anita and Ajit cried and refused to leave Grandma. Mrs. Priya, however, pulled them away from Grandma and returned home. Once they reached home, AJ and Anita was talking secretly among themselves.
Children, what are you all talking? Tell me.
Mom and Dad, can we go to the shop now? We want to get a piggy bank each to start saving money.
Piggy bank? Why suddenly? Good. Save money, less burden, right?
True, Father. It is actually for you both.
What are you saying? I don't understand.
Yes, Mom and Dad. We need to save a lot of money because in the future, you both also need to be sent to the old folks, right?
Anita and I were shocked to see the amount paid for Grandma's stay. So we decided to start it early.
Both parents then realized their mistakes. Suddenly, the powerful stream which was around Mr. Allen's hand started to pass. Mother and kids prayed to Swami.
Swami! Please help my husband, Swami! I know I have done a big mistake to my husband and also to my mother-in-law. Please, Swami, I need my husband back. Please!
Cannot replace the mother's love for her child.
is Bhagavan Baba himself. He loved his mother Ishwarama. Ishwarama came to Swami with tears in her eyes and said, "Swami, people want to take you here and there for their selfish purposes. If you leave Puttaparthi, I will give up my life. Please promise me that you will remain in Puttaparthi forever." "I gave her my word that I would never leave Puttaparthi." She also insisted three promises from Swami. First, a hospital for the sick. Second, a school for studying children. Third, clean water for people. Swami dedicated her wishes in a bigger scale, super specialty hospital, Sri Satya Sai Institute of Higher Learning, and Sri Satya Sai Water Project. This is the only result of Swami's sacred love for Ishwarama. Swami fulfilled her wish. That is the greatness of mother's love. That is why she could live a life of fulfillment and peace. In order to propagate this sacred ideal, this day is being celebrated as Ishwarama Day. This is to emphasize that each one of you should make your mother happy. When mother is happy, Swami is happy.
Thank you.